crazy how them tables turn. You can fold or you can stand firm. I'm a real one, so I ain't concerned. I'm fully built for this life. I think I earned all my stripes. I don't believe all the hype. Get back on my feet and get right. Watch you work, watch him hate, watch him lurk. Can't relate, watch you skirt. Out the mud, out the dirt, above the waters, in the murks, out the gate, on sight. Red breed, red tight, set the bar, take flight. Yeah, I been grinding since I'm young and they told me my timing was coming. I been hustling with no fun and forget all the fame, get the money. I'm out in LA where it's sunny. I been eating since I'm young and since we ain't have food in our tummy. The life we was living ain't funny, but you cannot take nothing from me. Put that on my mama, my daughter, my cousin, my brother, I'll show you. Way better than I can tell you. The type of dreams that they sell you. That's why I learned from my failures. Don't do the handouts or the favors. Told my brother I'ma get this paper. Was left behind, I'll see it later. To keep it real, you don't need to wait up. Lay it all on the line, ain't no looking back. Giving my all with no strings attached. Came from the bottom, rose through the cracks. Spotlight on you, behind you, where
I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. Now I get it go. 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 I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. Now I get it go. Sleeping with my ribs touched. Nah, I get it, it go. Nah, I get it, it go.
Yo, who tell us we ain't gonna win, man? Really? He's a bozo. Bozo.
Yeah, we did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on the team.
We are about 40 miles or so south of Candlestick Point at a place that first opened back in 2014. As you get a look at Levi's Stadium here in Santa Clara, California.
Ahead, we'll decide the second entrant to next week's NFC title game as we've got a great one in store between the Seattle Seahawks and the San Francisco 49ers. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The first carry for the shifty Tariq Cohen. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they...
Into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 34. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. And certainly, look, you're on the road in the playoffs. That is a suboptimal start, opening drive INT.
And, partner, sometimes I wonder, do these teams talk about it to such an extent that maybe you almost talk yourself into the turnover when you're trying to avoid it?
Yeah, maybe they get a little too worried about keeping the football, and then you give it to the other team right off the bat. And, look, we said it, on the road, this is just a terrible, terrible start for them.
It is, and now they've got to rely on their defense.
Brings up second and seven at the 31-yard line.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. They'll try the left side. It's Russell. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
That's a very nice game there. Confidence building run. Love the execution up front. And the way he pressed the hole, absolutely perfect.
Our game not even 2 minutes old, but a quick red zone opportunity. They come up first and 10 at the 16. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Throwing again. Jones.
into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off inside the 10. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So a pretty shaky start here for both sides.
Yeah, each quarterback's throwing a ball to the other team. Do you think on both sidelines they're sitting them down and saying, okay, remember, this is the color jersey we're wearing. They're wearing the other color. Let's make sure we get it to our guys, please.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. The gun, Cody, and that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
He'll drop this one down to Cohen, and he is not going to get to the marker as they stop him short at the 14. That'll bring up fourth down. They wind up getting 8 yards, but they needed more than that. On fourth down, ready to punt, Michael Dixon. Fielded at the 33. A nice return that time of about 14 yards. And the Niners will go on offense, first and 10. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
He was trying to hit Thomas that time, and it's third down.
Normally, being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
And he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. First down San Francisco, the pickup 14 yards. Here to his running back, and this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Second and 12, operating from the 39. They'll try the left side. It's Russell, and he's able to get more than half of what they needed. That brings up a third and 5.
But you've got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third manageable with that run.
From the gun on third down, Jones. And he will be marked down short of the first as they get to him at the 29. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
Well, we hear so often how tackling has become almost a lost art in the NFL game, but it's so important to tackle well on these receivers, especially in a play like this one. Third down, they gave him the underneath stuff. You got to go up and make the tackle right away.
And now before they run this play on fourth and 1, we're going to get a break and a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Chase McLaughlin now for the field goal try. From the right hash, it's a 46-yard attempt. And this one is right through. And the 49ers take a 3-0 lead. So that's a 7-play drive that ultimately stalls out there at the end.
And things were a little leaky in the beginning on that drive, weren't they? But how about the front 7? As they got closer to their goal line, things stiffened a little bit, forced the field goal.
The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
coming to the line here to begin their next drive. The Seahawks offense. They trail here early in this division round game as they seek a spot in the NFC title bout. The drive starts with a completion left side. And he'll be taken down by the face mask, it appeared. And yes, out come the flags. So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they'll march up another 15 against your squad.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave him 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
To throw on second down. Cody under pressure, and he will go down. Sack back at the 46. Javon Kinlaw busting through to get him for a loss of 6. Throwing on third and long. Cody going to throw right side here. Complete. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. They wind up getting 16, but even that's not quite enough. It's fourth down. Here's Michael Badgley ready for the field goal try. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right? Baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. And again this time to the tailback. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27th. These two rivals played 2 of the better games in the NFL a season ago. You remember week 17, it was Dre Greenlaw stopping Jacob Hollister at the 1 to preserve a 26-21 49er win. And that wound up both winning them the NFC West and earning them the number 1 seed. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
It's a gain of 3. Brings up 3rd and 4.
These two teams all tied after 1.
With the score tied 3-3.
Jones now. From the gun on 3rd down. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 2 catches now in this divisional round matchup. That one, a 1st down.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it. Sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
Here's Jones, off the play fake. Under pressure here, and down he goes. Sacked back at about the 43-yard line. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Quarterback gets hit.
So following the sack, they'll try to change their fortune here on 2nd and 13. Another try after the 1st down sack. Jones, and he's got his big tight end over the middle, complete. 23 yards the pickup there.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius, understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball, and puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
Now a play fake here on 1st down. That's complete. It's Brandon Ayuk. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
Seems as if the passing attack's starting to heat up a little bit here in the second quarter.
You can sense and you can see the momentum because now they're reading their patterns downfield, they're understanding the coverages, and they're finding the open holes in the defense.
And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They run the counter. Russell. And he's taken down after a gain of 3 as they move it from the 22 to the 19.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Now the Georgia Southern man, it's Matt Breida. And he's only going to get a yard from the 20 to the 19.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
The Niners on 3rd down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. Operating from the gun, Jones. Just what Seattle was hoping for. The coverage holds, and now 4th down.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on 3rd down.
And his kick is good. And the 49ers take a 3-0 lead. So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, Carter, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. So I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting 3? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find ones that get you into the end zone, get you 6?
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And it's been very much a slow start for them. 3 drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is 1, and that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. To throw again, Coney. And that one was nearly picked. Not sure he was accounting for the free safety. Now it brings up 3rd down.
Well, their first 2 drives only yielded 3 points. They might be thinking it's time to make something happen. Push the ball downfield and try and gain some points that way. Unfortunately, incomplete.
And he is going to have a Seahawks 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. 2 catches now in this divisional round matchup. That one, a 1st down. This is Cullen. And this winds up a pickup of 2, maybe 2.5 to about the 39. The ball carrier.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front. Because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked by Emmanuel Mosley, and they will take over possession of the football at their 42-yard line. You don't see this often, a quarterback of his caliber, 2 first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, David.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off. I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right? And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick 1st down. First down.
Let's go.
We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here. But a very eventful divisional round weekend. And only able to get two here. Stopped at the 30. Defensively, a solid response after giving up back-to-back first downs. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. And he'll give it here to his running back. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about four more for a first.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
A third field goal of the first half, not what they're looking for as they come up on third down. Throwing Jones. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks. 18-yard line. Could we get a touchdown in this first half after all? It's first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. He'll get this into the hands of Breida. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. Mark that as a gain of 16 to set him up first and goal.
So many times in my career I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing, but as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
They'll try to run with Hunt, and across the goal line, into the end zone, touchdown 49ers, taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Niners are able to stretch their lead.
And that's certainly an important score right there, because they gave themselves a 2-score cushion heading towards halftime. Now you got to force the other team out of their comfort zone, and it changes the way you approach the second half as well. How you want to do things on offense, and your defense feels much better too, having that lead.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And you have to figure they won't just sit on the football here in the final minute. The way things have gone, they need to try to make something happen offensively.
But maybe they should. Maybe they should sit on it here because of what you just said. They haven't made anything happen offensively. Getting ready to go into the half, give them a chance to take a deep breath, exhale a little bit, and start over. I don't know if this is the time to push it myself.
Yeah, right now, under 100 yards of total offense. Going right side here, and that's complete. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. On first and 10, Cody going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes these quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe you want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive. He's got the connection over the middle to Diggs.
Now the Seahawks call the second of their three timeouts as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one.
Third down.
The last play on the completion got them half of what they needed. Now here's a tough third and five. From the gun, Cody. And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's fourth down. And no move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and five. They're going to try and throw. Open man is Komet, the tight end. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call.
So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. And this will be spotted on the other side of the field. It's a 61-yard attempt.
And this won't get there. Won't be online either. It's no good. Off to the right. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC divisional round matchup. As we send you cross-country to Orlando, Jonathan Coachman is there and has our EA Sports halftime report. A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. A good balance attack for that last touchdown drive they had. Now it's time to see if they can do that again.
It really becomes a tale of two plays.
Try to force it to Allen, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 39. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line. Not the way you envision things to start out the third quarter. One play and already a turnover.
It's interesting. You and I were talking with the coach, and he talked about how at halftime, as a play caller, he wanted to make sure he got a new script going for the second half, not just the one that he operated off of to start the game. Nowhere on that script did it have that result.
18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that'll make it second and goal.
At the 49ers, 6-yard line.
Operating from the gun, Cody. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down.
Goal at the 6-yard line.
A big one coming in this divisional round playoff. Third and goal. From the gun, Cody. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
On second and 9, Jones looking for Ayuk, and he's got him. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. 2 catches now in this divisional round matchup. That one, a first down. Off play action, Jones. He'll buy some time right to the right side and complete to Thomas. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. On first down, it's Russell. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. In on the stop, the former Georgia Bulldog, Roquan Smith.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
From the 41, Jones. Throw left side, complete. It's Price. Touchdown, 49ers! Get into the end zone.
It usually involves a little bit of an extra move, doesn't it? You got to get them thinking that you're moving to the middle of the field and you're breaking away to that corner. But that was well executed.
Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good. And the lead now up to 14. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
Looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder, puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. Back to the air on second down. Cody. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. He's picked off at his own 47.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
They'll run on first down. Russell. And he's going to be met at about the 43. A gain of three, second down.
A big part of a middle linebacker's job is being able to take on blocks and then go make plays. But the best ones, they have those big guys in front of them playing defensive line to hold blockers off of them and allow them to flow sideline to sideline and make the big hits.
Second and seven, Jones. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. The linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
Now Jones from the gun on third down. Off to Thomas on the left side. And he is going to have a Niners first down as he's able to get 8 yards there on third and five. That catch puts him over 70 yards receiving now as he's got a first down. Operating from the gun, Jones. Flushed out right. His throw incomplete. The intended receiver there, Ian Thomas. And now it's second down.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
They need to get this to the 24 on third down. From the gun, Jones. Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. Aaron Donald in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that will lead to fourth down.
54-yard attempt.
And his kick here is good. And that'll push the lead up to 17. So three field goals that he's hit now. This last one helps him stretch out the lead.
He's been solid, hasn't he? And he lives up to the adage that every offensive coach has ever said to us. We want to end every possession with a kick, right? For them, it's either extra point, field goal, or at worst, a punt. In this case, it's been threes.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw.
He'll get that complete to his tight end, Komet.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here's second and a yard from the 34. Now Cohen.
Well, they certainly have been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got just pin their ears back and get after him now.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. Back to throw. Cody. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off at the 47. Second straight drive now here, Charles, and have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one, or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
The ball carried by number 24.
Up from his linebacker spot, Deion Jones making the play.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now, if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want, but on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
One quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Niners on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This is 3rd and 4. Now Jones. That's caught. It's Thomas. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. A 20-yard touchdown. And the Niners take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash this one in. And he'll bang that one through.
Makes the score Niners 30, Seahawks 6.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Their hopes of advancing past this divisional round hanging by a thread, if that, as they begin here with a 1st and 10 on the wrong side of the scoreboard. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call. Well, they'll get the yardage, but they hate to see him take that hit.
You're always trying to cool off a big-time guy throwing the ball. But you have to know when to back off, pull up, and not hit him. There's the penalty.
So now a fresh set of downs, 1st and 10 after roughing the passer. Operating from the gun, Cody. That's complete to DK Metcalf. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2. Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. From the gun, Cody. Left side caught by Diggs.
The pass.
And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. Hard to believe his first catch of the game defensively. They bottled him up. That's why they're well on their way to victory.
Put your best cover guy on him and then change the coverages behind him throughout the game. Brackets, double, zone, man, you name it. Make sure he gets a lot of angles.
3 yards the gain there, 2nd down.
It's a pickup of 3. Brings up 2nd and 7 at the Niners 40.
Operating from the gun, Cody. That's complete right side to Komet. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 32-yard line. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
First down.
Again, he'll drop to throw. A quick target here, complete to Metcalf. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
Seattle.
From the gun, Cody. And that incompletion breaks a string of five straight connections. And it's second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Throwing again on second and 10. Cody escaping the pressure right. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is...
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
That is now five interceptions that he has thrown in this ball game. If I asked you to speculate what's possibly going on in his head, what would you say?
Well, if he's as mentally strong as I believe he is, he understands that not all these picks have been his fault. You know, some of the throws, yes, but have been a good number of them where he hasn't been helped by his own receivers, and they've turned into interceptions. So he knows if he keeps firing, perhaps good things can happen, not just in this game, but especially in later ones.
And he's only able to work this from the 8 to the 10 for a pickup of 2. 2 yards gets him back to where they started, but now 3rd and 10. Shotgun, Breida, and he'll only get this to the 14 as he'll come up well short of the first down. It'll be a gain of 4, but it won't be enough. It leaves him with a fourth down now. And now it's the punter, Weil, on as he sends this one away. A 40-yard punt, 1 yard on the return, and it'll be Seahawk football first and 10.
44-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They knew this would be tough on the road, divisional round, and that has certainly been the case with the deficit they face in this fourth quarter.
And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
What we just saw there, that's really been a common theme all afternoon.
A lot of pressure. That forced the errant pass. He's been under duress this entire afternoon. He just had to unload that one. He's fortunate it was just incomplete and not intercepted.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
To throw on third down, Cody going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
What we've seen so far in this game, they are not going to allow a big shot over the top. You can have whatever you want underneath. They'll give you that, but they're not going to let you beat them deep.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Got to try it here. He's back to throw.
Over the middle, and that's caught by Kmet.
And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth from the 32 now. Here's first and 10. Operating from the gun, Cody. Over the middle, it's complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 13 yards as they've got the connection working. His second catch in a row, first down. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone for the Seahawk touchdown.
from 19 yards away.
And the Seahawks are able to close the gap just a bit.
So, my man, another touchdown. They're looking like the number one seed that they earned throughout the year. Looking pretty dominant right now.
We knew the road to the Super Bowl would run right through this stadium. Somebody's going to have to come in here and beat these guys. Good luck. I don't think it's happening this weekend.
No, definitely not this weekend. And for anyone else out there, bring your game.
Buyer beware. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And now first downs are key. They want to keep that clock moving up by two scores as they try to cement their place in the conference championship round in 1 week's time. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Another running situation on the doorstep as they come up second and 10. They'll keep it on the ground. It's Harper, and he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. On third down, a run from Breida. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. Call it an even 40-yard punt, 7, though, on the return. And that will come the offense as they take over.
Their own 36-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
From the gun on third down, Cody. And he comes back with one complete. And he is going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. From the gun, Cody, he's going to let it fly. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down.
Love the idea, love the concept, but you got to leave a little room on the sideline so he can fade into it when he makes the catch. That was thrown too close to it for the receiver to make a play.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. The intended receiver was DK Metcalf. And that takes us from second to third down.
Third down and 10 yards to go.
Operating from the gun, Cody. And that is incomplete.
My first thought is surprise because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
On fourth down, Cody. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. The linebacker, Fred Warner, right there on the coverage. Good starting field position for the 49ers as they have it first and 10 at their own 44. Now a handoff here to his running back. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2.
Brings up second and 2 on the Seahawks' 47-yard line.
Side moves on, and then of course there's the other side, and now